Now I'm going to show you how to get the custom sounds on the Keys ESCs, both the 32 amps and the 24 amps. So first you need to go to keys.fiorino.net, and then you get to this site, go to downloads, click on the Keys ESC 32 amps, and you see this Keys audio editor. Click on that and you just need to download it, and when it's downloaded, then you need to find it. I already downloaded it once, and then you just need to unpack it and drag all the components to a place you know it, where it is. So I have this folder I named Keys, and I named sound editor, and you see it like this. The next thing you need to do then is, let's start a new folder, and then you go to a new site on your web browser, Chrome to be exact. It doesn't work on anyone else. Go to more tools, extensions, and you see I have it on, have it here, so I'm just going to remove it. And then you need to load unpacked extensions. Then you need to find the folder you unpacked the sound editor to, and just click that and OK. And then you see you got it there, and you need to make it enabled to be able to hit the launch, then you get it like this. And the files you are able to use is, you can use both 8 and 16 bit WAV files. The program will automatically convert the 16 bits to 8 bits, so you don't get any better quality with 16 bits. But and the thing you need to do now is you can go to downloads again, hit the Keys 32 amp CSEs, and then you go to this firmware, the latest and greatest, and you click download. I already did it, but I can do it again. And then you see you get this zip file. You need to unpack it, and then you get the tool file and drag them to a place where you know we can find them. And I have in my Keys folder a map folder I call firmwares for the different stuff, so I have it here. And then you go to your sound editor, choose files, and you find the folder where you have your files, and then you click the one that says voice. If you click the one that says SBIP, you won't be able to get voices. And then you get it, you get this sound editor looking like this, and if you click this, you will hear the different voices that's already in it. And you need to delete all of this. You see down here, when I deleted three of them, I have 3.11 seconds free, or 9.12. So just keep deleting all of the files. You won't need them. And then you see you have 9.12 seconds. So that's the total length of file you can have on the ESC. And when you've done that, you can choose files. And then you need to find the place where you have your wave files. That are not more than 9.12 seconds long. If you try to upload that, it won't be able to play it. So I have different sounds I already edited here. So let's just take this one and open it. And then I have, you see here, it's 5 seconds long. That was a bad example. But if we take this one, some of the files will be slowed down for some reason. And the only thing you need to do then, when you have added the sound you want, is to click Save Hex. And you need to place it in the folder you will be able to find it. And I just name it like something in there, like this one I named Fat Bastard. I already got it, so I'm not going to save this one. So that's basically it. And for the KISS 24s, you just go to KISS ESC 24 amps on the KISS site. You found this firmware, the latest and greatest as well. Click download. And unpack it. And you do the exact same thing as before. The only difference is that you have much less time you can upload on the audio files. I think it's less than 2 seconds, 1.6 or something. You will find it out. So you just go to where you dragged out the file, same as before. Click the one with voice and open, and then you delete both of them. You see it's just 1.37 seconds, so that's not that much. But yeah, that's how you get the custom sounds on the KISS ESCs, both the old and the new. And it works with both KISS V2 and KISS V1 FCs. And the way to get it flashed on your quadcopter, you need to download the GUI. So just go to downloads again, KISS GUIs, and download the latest. For the version you need, 32 bits or 64 bits. I use the 64, so that's what I'm using. And just drag it over to a folder where you know we can find it. And I have this folder I called GUI and the different kind. So just open it, click the one that says KISS GUI, and then you need to connect your FC connected. You also need to remove all of your props for safety reasons. Then connect your battery to EC flasher. You know what you're doing. And then you go to select local firmware. Click the one you created. Open it. And then just click flash. And you should get some extra. Let's try to connect it again. Yeah. If you connect your battery before you connect your flight controller, you get this tab over here, so you can turn 3D mode on if you need that. Or reverse the direction on your ESCs if, for example, two of them are going the wrong way. As before. And be sure to click the right firmware, so you don't flash the 24 amps firmware on the 32 amps ESCs. Click open and flash. Now you see it's finished, then you just need to unplug your battery and your flight controller. There you have it. That's how you get custom sounds on your ESCs.